Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos and today we're going to answer the question, if one of my CBO campaigns is working, can I actually scale it? I get this question a lot and I really understand it. A lot of times people can be lazy, they don't think about creating other campaigns. Another thing that I'm thinking that people do is they believe Facebook a lot when it talks about consolidation. Well, in this channel, if you're watching the videos, most probably you understand that we are in a different level and in a different theory. We believe in stacking up campaigns. And the reason for that is not the Advantage Plus campaigns, which are new and you can actually scale by increasing the budget, but it's the CBO campaigns. The CBO campaigns, when they were introduced, we were not using them at the start, then we started using them a lot because they were working, and now they're working like 99% of the cases better than ABO campaigns. So in that specific situation, people were used from ABO campaigns and they started scaling CBO campaigns, but CBO campaigns were actually failing and they were losing all the ROAS and you had to start them all over again or start with other creatives and so on. The reason that this is happening is because a CBO campaign is having a budget, and of course if you're using just one ad set inside, it's like an ABO campaign, and this is the reason that we can scale also Advantage Plus, because it behaves like an ABO campaign with just one ad set. But when you have several ad sets and they have a distribution of budgets over there, they have actually decided to spend in specific hot pockets within the audiences that we are targeting. And of course we have the randomness of initial results, which means that if some of those ad sets, they had some better results and they took sales, they started optimizing in this hot pocket of the audience that they were targeting, they were getting budget. And when we go and we introduce more budget, maybe we are pushing them, maybe we're pushing the limits of the hot pocket, which means if one ad set is on 50 million, okay, and it's spending from the $200, the $100, and it's working very well, maybe if we push the budget to 300, 350, maybe another $50 on this specific ad set inside the CBO campaign, maybe they're going to cause an imbalance, which means that this ad set is going to try to find another $50 worth of sale with keeping the same ROAS, of course, but maybe this is not possible in the hot pocket that it's actually targeting, and maybe it has to find another pool audience of people, and if we are lucky enough, these people, they are going to convert and they are going to form another hot pocket. But if we are not lucky enough, what is going to happen is that the second hot pocket that has been created in this ad set is not going to work, which is going to make the ROAS of the total ad set to drop, which is going to make the ROAS of the total campaign to drop. For these reasons, and for the fact that when you have a CBO campaign, you have ad sets that they have already optimized in specific hot pockets, but also because of the reason that whenever you're going to increase the budget, you might disturb the balance that we have created with leaving some ad sets and closing some others by having them spend the right amount daily so that they can produce the ROAS that we want. I don't like to scale CBO campaigns, and I like to create new ones. And one way of scaling, it's either you have a CBO campaign with different interests, you take one of the interests, you use it on Crazy Method. If you don't know Crazy Method, you have to go watch my video. Another way is that you're having a CBO which is working with $200, you duplicate it, you put more ad sets inside, and you run it the next time with $400 in order to see if you can create more hot pockets within this audience or audiences that they have been working, and so on and so on. You can stack up campaigns. This is the way that I like to operate with CBO campaigns, and the way that I like to optimize them and keep them and not scale them like this, because in my way of thinking, and something that I have seen several times happening, when you're having one ad set, it's working, then you scale it to 300, boom, perfect, it's working, 400, 500, 600. Eventually, you are going to do a mistake of scaling that much, and it's not in your hand. It's up to how much it can support in a specific hot pocket, and you're going to lose your whole campaign. What's the point of doing that when you can do 5 or 6 or 7 campaigns, and when you do one mistake there, you're going to just lose one campaign and not all the other ones that they help you actually scale your ad account. So for CBO campaigns, whatever is working, we are not touching it. We have a balance in our CBO campaign. What my CBO optimization video, my Crazy Method video, and all of the other videos that they have as case studies on how to optimize CBO campaigns. Don't forget, if you want to learn more about Facebook ads, you can check my book or my free course. And until we meet again, guys, be creative and be consistent.